We all know Tomb Raider used to just be for sofa wankers. That's just historical facts. I mean, look at this.
Hello, I'm Alison Carroll, and I'm the new face of Lara Croft.
Christ, who made this?
IGN.com.
Oh, for f***. It's a different time now, though, and in our more enlightened age, Tomb Raider came back, and instead of her key characteristic being having massive tits, it's now dying f***. Loads, and everyone's very happy about it. In that respect, Shadow of the Tomb Raider does not disappoint. Crystal Dynamics have been making these Lara Croft games for a bit now, and it's a real passion project for them. They reinvented this character for a new generation, and you can really see how much it means to them.
It's been an honor to be able to work on Tomb Raider, and long may it continue.
What do you mean enough doing this one? I get it. They f***ed off with the first sniff of that Marvel bunch, didn't they? And left Eidos Montreal to finish off their trilogy for him. Don't worry though, the new nerds know exactly what we want. Lara getting all boshed up and having a shit time? Check. Boshing up ancient places even though the locals don't want her to? Check. Boshing up monkeys? Check, check, check. Everything's basically the same as you remember it. Lara's accidentally touched some magic Mexican cutlery that makes the world start to end. Then she's gone to Peru to find, I don't know, something else. A Mayan pipe? A special brick? Look, as soon as the violence stops and that English accent starts going, I pretty much switch off.
He wants to alter the course of humanity.
Shut up. Anyway, the plane crashes and she's straight back in survivor mode, getting naughty kisses from Maury Eels and that. Can we just stop for a second though? Because something's doing my head in. Has it ever been a pilot that's tried to help Lara and not died? Has she got like some bad plane juju or something? Look, this rescue plane? F***ed. Old World War II plane? F***ed. Even boats, the planes of the sea aren't safe. What is she doing on these f***ing planes? I hear the buns is pretty good if you're a pilot and that, so why do they even bother with her? Anyway, I just made sure this latest pilot got it worst of all. Not only did he crash in a jungle, he also got his legs bit off by a jaguar. Lo siento, Miguel. Lo siento, bat. At least the jaguar's wicked, though. Bosses in other games are f***ing monsters or just a big floating face. But Eidos Montreal understands this. And in real life, a boring old jaguar would be a boss for most of us. It takes a battering, too. I reckon I stuck about 15 arrows in his head before it went down. The twist? There's another jaguar after that. Did they just sink f***ing loads of money at the top-notch jaguar physics or what?
Yes, they sunk f***ing loads of money into top-notch jaguar physics.
The big change in this game, apart from all the jaguars, is that Lara can go full snake eater and cover herself in muck to hide in special muddy bushes. The point is she can jump out and gank a naughty man without them ever knowing. But I think there should be bonus points for scaring them because you look like f***ing Pazuzu. Eidos Montreal is doing a bang up job of pretending to be Crystal Dynamics, and I'm into it, I gotta say. Basically, if you like the other Grim Tomb Raiders, you're some more Grim Tomb Raider for you. If you're the sofa wanker type, you just have to keep waiting until they inevitably reboot the reboot. I hope we can all agree, at least, the shooting this frog is hilarious. If you like that, then what about this Spider-Man video I've done that loads of people have been watching? Or, I tell you what, no f***ing watch though, this one I did about pure farming or farming simulator or whatever it's called. You lot are f***ing pathetic. Watch it.